Lizzie.
That fella who reckons he's a teacher's not worth talking to.
Look, I don't know what was going on, but you've got to remember to take it easy with her. Apart from the fact that she's 72, she's just out of hospital.
Yes, I know, Jim, but she said she wanted to be a lawyer. All I said was how ridiculous it was. I mean, what else could I say?
Yeah, well, that's your problem. Just don't upset them, that's all. That's how trouble starts.
Mr. Andrews is doing some work in the library, if any of you wish to help.
I will, Miss Bennett.
Look at Miss Goody Two-Shoes.
That's enough, Smith. And for the central anyone else? Districts, cool and cloudy,
with showers becoming mainly confined
to the coast. Lord, Lord, methought what pain it was to drown. What dreadful noise of water in mine ears. What nights of ugly death within mine eyes. Methought I saw 1,000 fearful wrecks, 1,000 men that fishes gnawed upon. Isn't that wonderful stuff?
Yeah.
Wedges of gold, great anchors, heaps of pearl, unestimable stones, unvalued jewels.
Oh, no, he was just giving you mouth-to-mouth resuscitation.
Well, it wasn't David, Mr. Andrews' fault. You see, I kissed him.
I didn't notice him fighting you off.
Oh, but Mr. Fletcher...
But nothing, Burns. I saw what I saw. And I'll make my report to the governor. No doubt you can tell her your story. But I doubt if either of you will get off scot-free.
Oh, heck.
What's up?
Bloody Fletch walked in on Mr. Andrews and me.
What do you mean, walked in on you?
Well, we're in the library together, and it was really romantic, you know, and there was just the two of us together, you know?
Yeah.
I kissed him.
You what?
Oh, talk about a fast work.
No doubt about you, Doreen. You're always in bloody trouble.
No, well, the way Fletch is carrying on, I reckon David's in more trouble than I am.
Wouldn't be surprised. He'd probably lose his job over it.
Good riddance. If he doesn't want to teach us what we want to know, what's he doing here?
Well, it wasn't his fault. I thought I should sort of... well, take my chance while I could.
Yeah, OK. Well, you got caught, didn't you? Now, listen, if the screws think he's to blame, you let them. Tell them he made a pass at you.
Can't do that. He didn't do anything.
Listen, regardless of what happens to you, he is going to walk out of here as free as a bird.
He's right, you know, love. He won't be here long anyway. I mean, he's bloody useless. So what's the point in risking loss of privileges or even the pound for the likes of him?
But it wasn't his fault.
Look, Jim, I think you might have got the wrong impression before.
I don't think so. It was quite obvious.
Well, it might have been to you, but I had no idea she was going to do that.
Oh, come on. You may not have worked in women's prisons before, but you must have known that these women have got normal sexual feelings.
Do you think I encouraged her?
I think you should have realized that they'll go after anything in pants.
Oh, what a bloody chauvinistic attitude.
Yeah, well, that may be so, but it's the truth. And it's the duty of every officer or education officer to recognize it. Now, that's your job. You're not teaching six-year-olds now, you know.
No, I wish I was. They're less trouble.
I can't understand it. If you were teaching high school kids and one of them developed a crush on you, you wouldn't let it get out of hand now, would you?
Yes, I admit I've been a bit blind to Doreen. I just didn't think. I am new to this game.
That's only common sense. If you haven't got any of that, you shouldn't be working here in the first place.
No.
You realize I'll have to report this to Mrs. Davidson?
Yes. Yes, I suppose you will.
Do you reckon he will get the boot, Lizzie?
I don't know, love. Probably. But you don't need to feel bad about it.
Why not? It was my fault.
Nah. If he hadn't wanted you to, he wouldn't have let you.
You reckon?
Of course. Don't go getting your hopes up, Lizzie. What do you mean?
Whether he does or he doesn't make any difference. I mean, they're hardly going to give him the use of a cell for a couple of hours now, are they?
You're very crude sometimes, Bee. There's more to being with a bloke than that.
Oh, is there really, Lizzie?
Of course. Take me and Sid. I mean, we're too old for that sort of thing, but we just like talking.
Yeah, well, I like just talking to David, too.
Well, it's a pity you didn't do a little more talking and a little less necking.
It was just one kiss.
And look at the trouble it caused.
Oh, nothing's going to come of me and Sid. Still, it's nice while it lasts.
Yeah, you're right. Well, I suppose you've got to grab your chance while you can. Like when Ken used to come in here. I knew it wasn't going to do me any good, but you've got to make the most of it.
Yeah, well, see, that's what I was doing, B. See, that's what I was doing, grabbing my chance.
Yeah, well, now your chance is gone, kiddo. You blew it, kaput. So there's no point brooding over it. All you can do now is sit back and wait until the next time.
I'll make the necessary arrangements. Thank you. Goodbye. Good morning, Mr. Fletcher.
Good morning.
That was the hospital. They've made an appointment for Lizzie at 2 p.m. this afternoon. Could you organize that?
Yes, just a checkup.
Yes. Oh, and Mrs. Knox has reported a leak in the hot water system in D Block. Would you ask Mr. Humphreys to check it when he comes in?
Right.
Do you have anything for me?
Yes, I wanted to see you about David Andrews.
Oh?
I went to collect Burns from the library last night and, well, they were kissing.
What? What was she doing in there at that time of night?
Well, apparently, Miss Bennett asked for volunteers to help in the library. Burns jumped at the chance. It's easy to see why now.
Oh. Well, did you speak to Mr. Andrews about it?
Yes, last night. It didn't do much good.
Have you made a written report?
No, I thought I'd talk to you about it first.
I'm glad you did. I'll speak to both of them.
Well, I don't think Burns is entirely to blame. The way that Andrews treated Lizzie shows that he's got no idea how to handle these women.
Lizzie? It seems there are quite a few things I don't know about.
Well, come on, you lot. Hurry up. Move it.
Now, Vera, make a good drover. What do you reckon, Lizzie?
Now, she'd run all the fat off the cows and make them all scrawny like me.
If you'd prefer cleaning the toilets to washing in the laundry.
Oh, I'm just going, Vera.
See you later, Dor.
Yeah, have a good time at school today, Doreen. I hear he's starting sex education.
What was that, Kent?
Nothing, Miss Bennett. If you're maligning an officer, you'll find yourself in solitary.
No, it was just a joke. Something we're talking about at breakfast.
Yeah, about a new teacher, Randy Andy.
Hey. I've warned you, Smith.
Did you warn us about Mr. Andrews? I don't think he did. Then he would touch you, probably.
What are you talking about?
He was over Doreen like a rash last night.
Now, that's enough of that. Now, get to the laundry.
Don't believe me. Ask Mr. Fletcher. He saw it all.
Get to the laundry. And you're late for your lesson.
Well, all I can say is that I'm sorry. I guess all the signs were there, but I didn't recognize them. I can assure you I never encouraged her at all.
Well, that's as may be, but you must realize in a prison situation, any little attention can be exaggerated out of all proportion.
Well, I can't ignore her.
Of course not, but you must bear it in mind at all times. You have a responsible position and you are expected to act accordingly. You must avoid the situations before they happen.
Yes, well, I'm sorry.
You do have a lot to learn, David.
Don't I know it?
I'm afraid I can't afford the possibility of the incident occurring again until I am sure you are capable of handling it.
But you're not going to close the school?
No, of course not. It's far too early to do anything that drastic, but I can't allow you to be alone with Doreen.
Oh, fine. It'll be a relief to have an officer there as a chaperone.
That is not what I meant. We are short-staffed as it is, and I cannot allocate an officer to the school.
But Doreen's my only pupil. Worth and Shepherd dropped out.
Yes, I know. That's what I meant when I said you have a lot to learn. You'll have to find some way of attracting the women to your classes. Until you do, you're going to be very lonely sitting in the library without anyone to teach.
You must meet my husband. He's a mad cricket fan, too.
Oh, I'd like that.
Hi, Julie.
Morning, Julie.
Good morning. Oh, Meg, I've had to roster you to take Lizzie to the hospital this afternoon.
Oh, okay. But isn't there anyone else with a car?
No, there isn't. The only driver is Linda Knox, and her car's in for a service. I'll have a taxi docket waiting for you.
Nothing serious, I hope.
No, just a checkup. Sid, I'd like you to take a look at the hot water service in D Block.
Yeah, all right. Anything else?
Yes, I've got a list of jobs drawn up for you in the staff room. I'll get them to you later.
Mr. Fletcher.
Later, Miss Bennett, please.
Well, he's in a lovely mood this morning. Yes, I don't know what's upset him. Have you heard anything about Burns and David Andrews?
No, but then again, I've only just walked through the door.
Well, I heard Mr. Andrews made a pass at Burns last night.
Who told you that?
I just heard. Anyway, I wasn't really surprised. I didn't think he was right for this place.
Is anyone, Vera?
He's not here to take advantage of the women.
Of course not. But until I know the full story, I'm not going to comment.
Morning, Miss Bennett.
Oh, morning, Mr. Fletcher. Could I be let through into the library, please?
The damn thing shouldn't be locked. See, you after last night, you'd be lucky to be allowed to go.
Yeah, I'm real sorry about that.
Well, you can make your apologies to the governor. She wants to see you.
Did Mr. Andrews get into trouble?
It's none of your business, Doreen. Now move.
Oh, it'll be lovely to have an afternoon out.
You ought to go into the hospital. I can think of better places.
Well, at least get me out of this dump for a while.
Getting out of this dump for a while didn't seem to do Jude any good.
Yeah. Poor old Judy. Hey, where's she gone with all that dirty washing? She should have been back ages ago.
The way she's been lately, we'll be lucky if she's back by lunch.
Poor old Jude.
Yeah. We thought we had troubles when we were stuck in that bloody drain. Well, well, look what the cat dragged in. And what's up with you?
Your bloody fault. What'd you have to go and tell Vera about me and David for?
She would have heard from Fletch sooner or later, and it's better she hear our version first. Anyway, how come you aren't at classes? Have they given him the bullet already?
No, because they won't let him and me be on our own, and no one else gives a damn, and so the classes have been cancelled.
Here's he come, here's he go.
Well, Lizzie, you'd come, wouldn't you?
No, I wouldn't, rude bugger he is.
Well, he was only telling you straight. You're too old to be a lawyer. Why don't you take up pottery or finger painting or something?
Because I'm not interested.
Be?
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't mind learning a trade. How about locksmith?
Oh, be serious.
Oh, serious, be buggered. Listen, when I was your age, I was in love with Peter Finch, and I had about as much chance of getting off with him as you do with David Andrews.
Me with Errol Flynn.
Look, love, there is no point pining after something you can't have. Understand?
Aha. A couple of chairs, eh?
Hello, Sid. Care to join me?
Oh, no. I'd better get on. I just came in to look for the list Mr. Fletcher left for me.
Hmm. Didn't he give it to you?
No.
Is this it?
Looks like a nice, easy day for me. Well, this won't take long. Oh, Mrs. Morris. Oh,
Meg, please.
Meg. Yeah, I wonder, could I take you and Mrs. Birdsworth to the hospital this afternoon?
I don't think so, Sid.
Well, it'd save the prisoner taxi fare. I mean, I do work here.
Oh, it's because you're a member of the staff that I can't encourage your friendship with Lizzie. I mean, you have to follow regulations, the same as we do.
Yes, I suppose you're right. Does seem a bit silly, though. I mean, well, we're not likely to get up to any hanky-panky there, right, are we? No, I just like having a chat to someone of my own generation now and then. Don't get out much at home.
All right, then. But as long as you don't spread it around, I'll meet you outside the main gates at 1:30.
I'll be there.
Well, you didn't take long to show your true colours.
What are you talking about?
I've just been speaking to Mr. Fletcher about that delightful exhibition last night. All the women are up in arms about it.
About what? You've got hold of the wrong end of the stick, Vera.
Oh, I don't think so. We've had people like you in here before. Full of fancy ideas, but only interested in one thing. Using these women for their own disgusting ends.
Oh, that is almost laughable. When I first came here, you made me think the women were animals of some sort.
Well, you obviously took me literally.
Now, look, how about hearing my side of the story?
I've heard the facts from Mr. Fletcher. Now, I take my job very seriously, Mr. Andrews. And as far as I'm concerned, these women should be protected against men who abuse their authority. And that obviously includes you.
At this rate.
Oh, sorry, Lizzie. Just that I feel so bad about what happened to Dave, and I can't even get to see him to apologize.
All right. That does it. I'm sick to death of you mooning around like some kind of lovesick calf, Doreen. Now, I've tried being nice, and I've even tried mollycoddling you, but the old patience is wearing just a bit thin. Now, you buck yourself up or you go and work somewhere else.
All right, Lizzie. Time to... What's the matter here?
Oh, nothing, Mrs. J.
Come on, Mrs. Morris, now.
Sorry, I wasn't thinking.
All right, Lizzie, time for your appointment.
Beauty! See you later, girls.
Hey, slow down, otherwise you have another attack.
Who, me? I'm as strong as an ox. Me old ticker's gonna last a long time yet.
Struth, talk about service. Taxi door to door. Who said Wentworth wasn't like a hotel?
Quite a few people, Lizzie.
I remember when I was on the outside, that's when they found out that I shouldn't have been in all them years. I went into town for a drink, Young and Jackson's. I hadn't been there for years, so I took a taxi. Anyway, the taxi driver must have been Italian or Russian or a Pom or something because I couldn't understand a word. And he took me miles out of me way just because he couldn't speak plain English. Mind you, I wouldn't mind if this bloke today took us for a few miles around the back block.
Oh, I think our driver will know where he's going, is he?
Sid! Why
What are you doing here?
Oh, I'm the prison chauffeur for the day.
Beauty! Good old Davey. I mean, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, Lizzie, I don't think Mrs. Davidson actually knows about this arrangement. Not that she would
don't
mind.
Don't you worry, Mrs. Jackson. Mum's the word.
Elizabeth, it's Mrs. Morris now.
She'll always be Mrs. Jackson to me.
Thanks, Bill.
Thank you.
Hi. It's Hazel, isn't it? Hazel Kent?
Yeah.
You're doing a good job there.
Thanks. I want to be an expert by now. I've been doing it all my life.
Is that right? It's a job?
Sometimes. Sometimes I got a job in a factory or a supermarket or something.
What'd you do when you first left school?
What is this? You want my life history or something?
I'm not a very subtle salesman. I just want to know why you haven't signed on for any classes.
Schoolwork? Sure. Who needs it? A bit late for me.
Sure. If you like cleaning floors.
Look, I went to school till I was 14. I had a load of rubbish stuffed down my throat about triangles and adjectives and William the Bloody Conqueror. What's the use of that? When I left, I didn't know what a bank was for. Couldn't even handle a little bit of money I was getting. Got kicked out of my room by some bastard of a landlord. They never teach you at school about how to handle any of that. What's the use of maths and English when you can't even handle shopping for groceries?
Yeah, I take your point. Look, if I could tee up something that would be of more use to you on the outside, would you be prepared to come along?
Yeah, I suppose. I'm not that keen on scrubbing floors.
Thanks.
Ever run into any of them during the war?
Run into them? I was running a mess hall up in Brisbane for a few months. You wouldn't imagine the sort of things I used to get up to.
Wouldn't I just?
Sorry to interrupt, but we've arrived.
So we have. Better get going, huh? Thanks for the lift, Sid. It was beaut having a chat away from all them bars and fences.
Yeah, I enjoyed it too. Now, Elizabeth, you listen to those doctors. They do know what they're talking about.
Okay, Sid. I won't give them no arguments.
Good. Off you go. I'll wait.
Oh, Sid, I think we'd better get a taxi back.
Oh, fair enough. See you ladies later then.
Thanks again, Sid. He's a very nice man, that one.
Yes. Well, come on. I think we better find you a very nice doctor.
Doreen?
Oh, David.
Hey, what's going on?
I just want to speak to Doreen for a moment.
It's okay, B. I'm sorry about what happened last night.
Let's just forget about what happened last night.
But I got you into trouble with Mrs. Davidson.
Well, it wasn't altogether your fault. I should have let you know where I stand. Now, I don't want you to think that I don't like you, Doreen, because I do, but I can't let it go any further. You do understand that, don't you?
Yeah, of course.
I think it's unfair that you've been stopped from attending my classes, but, well, we've all got to follow the rules.
Yeah, sure.
Mr. Andrews, may I ask why you're interrupting a work period? You are aware of Mrs. Davidson's ruling about Burns?
Naturally, Miss Bennett. Doreen Burns is not to be alone with me, but as you can see, we're hardly alone.
Then what are you doing here?
I came to announce a new course I intend to bring in.
First I'd heard of it.
What was that, Smith?
I said I wish you'd get on with it.
Well, you've all given me your opinions about the course I was going to run. It's obvious I have to rethink my program. Now, the Education Department has recently introduced a course called Modern Living, which deals with household budgeting, simple accounting, buying real estate. You know, a course designed to help you cope with everyday living.
Oh, great. I buy real estate every day of the week. It'll come in real handy.
Well, it'd be of more use to you than algebra or English grammar. Anyway, have a think about it and let me know. Thank you, Miss Bennett.
Now get back to work. All of you.
Isn't he terrific?
Oh, wake up, Australia. What is it going to take to make you realise he is not interested in you.
He is. He just had to say all that sort of stuff in case Mrs. Davidson kicked him out. He's gone out of his way to get this special course going just so I can go back to his classes.
Yeah, protecting his job's more like it. Not going to pay a teacher who hasn't got any students, now are they?
Yeah, he's protecting his job. Well, that's all right. He's got to live. Just you wait. We're going to have something real special going for us soon.
Taxi, ladies?
I said we were getting a taxi back.
Oh, well, you weren't long and I got nothing to drag me home.
That's not the point. I shouldn't have let you drive us in the first place. Now you know that.
Oh, dear. Well, seems a bit silly, though. I mean, go past Wentworth on the way home.
Waste of money catching a cab.
I thought you lived next door to Colleen Powell.
Yeah, well, yes.
Well, that's in the opposite direction.
Good Lord, so it is.
Is that all you've got to say?
Yes.
Oh, well, come on, where's the car?
This way.
The last time I had a day out like this, I mean, apart from me release, was when Mrs. Davidson took me to visit me brother Angus on his deathbed. It was his dying wish, the silly old bugger. Well, on the way back, we stopped at a park, and we got out and we sat there watching the ducks on the lake, just chatting, me and Mrs. Davidson.
Yeah, I know, of a nice little park on the...
Definitely, absolutely, and positively, no.
I spent some time in Augathella too. Suppose everybody does who works in the outback, sometime or another.
That where you met your husband?
No, that was years before. Poor old Blossom. That's what they used to call him.
How'd he come by that name?
I don't know. I was introduced to him as Blossom, and that's how I called him till the day he shot through on me.
What was his real name?
Tennyson.
Oh, you're joking.
No, Tennyson. His folks was mad on poetry. His brother's name was Byron.
Well, could have been worse. They might have called him Wordsworth.
Huh? Oh, Wordsworth, Birdsworth.
You know, it's a real pity I didn't meet you before. I mean, before you were released. You could have come and stayed at my place instead of that halfway house.
Yeah, that would have been good.
Oh, you could have done a bit of housework, you know, just to earn your keep.
Yeah. Still, I'll be getting out in 12 months or so. Maybe I could come then if the offer still holds good.
Oh, it will.
Yeah. Helen and Josie have set up in America by then. Yeah, that could work out real good. You're not a member of the Temperance League, are you?
Me? No. I like a spot now and then.
Oh, good on you. So do I.
I hate to break up the party, but if I don't get back to work soon, I could lose my job.
Sorry, Mrs. M. I got a bit carried away. I've really enjoyed myself today.
So have I. Yeah, better get back now.
I'll say one thing for him, he's got a silver tongue. Mrs. Morris was determined we weren't going to go to the park, but he soon talked around.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't fancy his chances with Vera.
But what about the tests, Lizzie?
Oh, me ticker, like I said, strong as an ox. Anyway, just as we got in the park...
Hey, Jude, do you fancy joining us for a foursome?
What?
A game of cards.
Oh, no, no thanks.
What's up with her?
I don't know. Would to hell she'd snap out of it.
All right, pay attention. This is Sandra Hamilton. She'll be staying in this block. Smith, you can introduce her around.
Sure thing, Vera.
Oh, sorry, Miss Bennett. What'd you get, love?
3 whole weeks for driving without a license.
Just a baby. This is Lizzie and Doreen.
Hi. Hi.
Is it your first time in, love?
Yes. Over here we've got Lorna, Lil, Bev, and that's Judy.
Oh, you're Judy Bryant, aren't you? I've seen you on the TV. Oh, well, that's terrific. As long as you didn't listen to the words.
I enjoyed it. I mean, I thought it was
Great. I thought you were great, the way you exposed all those rotten things in prison.
Rotten things? Now, that is a dead issue. You don't see anything rotten here, do you?
Come on, Sandra. How about joining us for a game of cards?
Okay.
How'd you get picked up, love?
It's a long story.
Listen, one thing we are not short of here is time.
Morning, Meg.
Morning, Vera. How's everything?
All right. Meg, did I see Sid Humphrey drop you and Birdsworth off at the front gate yesterday?
Yes. Why?
I thought it was him. You're taking a bit of a risk, aren't you?
All right. I know what you're getting at. And no, I shouldn't encourage personal relationships between the prisoners and members of the staff. However, I do think this is perfectly harmless.
Oh, well, why not? It seems to be a trend amongst all the male staff to bend the rules to suit themselves. If Mrs. Davidson condones David Andrews' behaviour, then...
I heard that was all Doreen's doing.
No doubt it was. You can expect anything from these women, her in particular. But you'd think someone who had been granted the authority to look after the prisoners could act with some responsibility.
I couldn't agree with you more, the way he acts reflects on all of us.
Well, that's the pot calling the kettle black, if ever I heard it.
What do you mean?
Well, I would have thought you'd be the last one to comment on personal relationships with the prisoners.
I have never touched any woman under this roof. I've got more respect for my position in here.
It's a pity others don't share your views.
Morning, ladies. Rise and shine.
Good morning, Mrs. Morris. Morning, Jude.
Yeah.
Oh, top of the morning to you, B. And the same to you, Jude. My, aren't we a happy little bunch.
And go to the showers now. Then you'll come back, make your bed and tidy your cell. After that, there will be a bell for muster, and then you go to breakfast. These ladies will show you where the showers are.
Ah, hi, B. Doreen. Lizzie.
What do you know? Human being, first thing in the morning. You better stick with me, kid. There's not many of us left.
True. Who's this group?
Oh, that's Mrs. Morris.
Used to be Jackson.
Oh, seems decent enough.
Oh, she is. You wait till you get to know Vinegar Tits.
Which one's she?
Oh, you know, Miss Bennett. Stick you in the pound, soon as look at you.
The pound?
Solitary.
Oh, right. Have you got any weed on you? Got some tailors in myself.
Wouldn't leave them lying around, have you?
Don't worry, I've got them well hidden.
What's up, B?
Oh, nothing. I don't think.
Are you going to be coming to the classes they have in here?
I didn't know they had any.
Oh, yeah, they've only just started up with Mr. Andrews. He's the teacher and he's real good.
When Judy was on the TV,
well, you see, it was because of Judy that we got the teacher in here, because the governor went on to the TV program and she said that what Judy had been saying was a whole lot of rubbish, so they had to do something pretty quick smart just to make it look...
Hamilton, good. You're here for a shower, not a gossip.
That's Vinegar Tits. I was just telling her about the classes, Miss Bennett.
Thanks, Doreen. But I don't think I'll bother. I mean, I'll only be here for 3 weeks. Oh, why don't you wash your teeth while you're waiting? Might stop you talking for 5 minutes.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
Good morning, Judy.
Is it?
But Miss Bennett's a bit of a monster, isn't she?
Yeah.
She one of the reasons you did that videotape.
Vinegar? She's tame compared to Gillespie. He had his way, he had machine gun turrets on the bloody roof.
Was he a screw too?
They're all screws.
But did he have more authority than the governor?
Well, how the hell should I know? Ask the department.
Judy, how did you make that tape? I mean, did you have friends in television or something?
Listen, if you think that I'm going to stand around here having a big conversation with you in the middle of my shower, you got rocks in your head.
Sorry, I just thought that you must
have... Oh, put a cork in it, will you?
Hey, Sandy, something you have to learn about this place is that we respect each other's privacy. Now, if they don't want to talk to you, don't press it. Got it?
Got it. Sorry.
Hey, am I interrupting?
Not at all.
No assignments to correct?
No clients. I'm waiting on some new material to come from the education department. Hopefully, I'll be able to drum up some business with that. I haven't exactly made a good impression since I arrived.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. Vera thinks she has a very good impression of you.
Yes, I was referring more to the prisoners, but I haven't made many friends among the staff either.
Well, both Vera and Jim can be difficult at times.
Look, I honestly didn't realise about Doreen.
Don't have to explain that to me. I know what Doreen's like. Actually, she's had a pretty rough couple of years. As far as I'm concerned, you're not excommunicated.
Thanks. Well, that's a help. My biggest job now is to try and talk Jim and Vera around.
Well, in the interest of better learning conditions, I'd say you're right.
I don't know which one's going to take the more persuading.
Hi.
Hi.
I just came round to see if you're going to go to those classes or not.
I don't really think it's worth it, Doreen. I'm only going to be here for 3 weeks.
Oh, that doesn't matter. You could go even if you're only going to be in here for a day.
You seem rather eager to get me in there.
Oh, it's up to you, of course, but they did go to the trouble of getting a teacher in.
Oh, come on. There's more to it than that.
Oh, well, it's just that David, Mr. Andrews, well, him and me, we're sort of, well, it's nothing really. It's just that I think he's pretty nice and I'd like to see him do well with his school.
Uh-huh. I see.
Well, he'd feel the same about me, I know. It's just that he's not allowed to, you know, being as good as a screw and all that.
Must be really hard for you. So near and yet so far.
Yeah. But that's why I've got to get somebody to go to the classes with me so that I'm not his only pupil, see?
Why?
Well, I got him into some trouble. And I feel real bad about it. I'd like to give him a present or something, you know, to make up for it.
Why don't you?
Well, I haven't got anything to give him.
My boyfriend's coming to visit me this afternoon. Maybe I could get something from him.
Oh, you couldn't get him to smuggle anything in.
Why not? Doreen, there are ways to get things past the screws. You must know that.
How are you going to do it?
Just you let me worry about that.
Hello, Vera. May I join you?
The staff room for the use of all staff.
I'm getting some copies of the Modern Living course sent over sometime today. Special delivery. The department gets off its bum occasionally, doesn't it?
Your department or mine?
Look, I'm sorry about what happened with Doreen, Vera. I don't know what else to say. I mean, I could have kicked myself for letting it happen.
I don't doubt it.
My mistake was that I tried to treat them like a bunch of underprivileged kids. That's because I'm a teacher by profession, not a prison officer. If I'd had your experience and training, I would never have thought that way. Now, I probably did encourage Doreen to some extent, but it certainly wasn't intentional. With an 8 or 9-year-old, you can pay them the same sort of attention without having it being taken the wrong way. I'm just not used to relating to adults on either side of the fence.
You're not dealing with people who behave normally. It was a ridiculous mistake to make.
True.
You've got to assert your authority or they'll walk all over you.
Yes, I know. Look, all I'm asking is that please don't let what happened spoil the good working relationship that we had.
Well, I'm not one to hold a grudge.
Neither am I.
Hi.
No touching, Hamilton.
I'm sorry, Mr. Fletcher.
You getting on all right?
Oh, yes, yeah, fine. How's Granny?
Oh, she's fine. Yeah. Looking forward to hearing from you.
Yeah.
You know, it's her birthday on the 4th, don't you?
The 4th?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, of course, the 4th. Tell Granny that I've met that prisoner, the one we saw on the telly.
Judy Bryant?
Yes, that one.
No talking about the other prisoners, Hamilton. Just keep it personal, okay?
Well, then I'm going to need a present.
What for?
Granny, if it's her birthday, you know, I'll need a present.
Oh, right. Yeah. What should I get her?
I thought of perfume, and I thought of jewellery, but then she already has so many rings.
Well, how about a brooch or a pendant or something?
A brooch? Yes, that'd be terrific, wouldn't it? Oh, but I'm going to need to give you some money.
Oh, no, it's all right. You can pay me when you get out.
Oh, Gary, you are so sweet.
Hamilton.
Oh, no touching. Well, thanks. Granny is going to be very, very pleased.
Yeah. So tell me, how they've been treating you?
Oh, not bad. In fact, it's better than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah? Food's all right, isn't it?
Hey, Jude, you fancy giving me a spell in the press for a while?
What's up, love?
With me, nothing.
Oh, come on, you are not your usual chirpy self. Now, Auntie B listens to everyone's problems, even yours.
I don't know what's wrong. It's just everything seems to be getting on top of me lately.
You had a pretty rough trot in the outside, didn't you?
It all started in the tunnel. Poor Irene getting killed. Seems everybody I get involved with drops dead. Irene, Sharon...
Sharon's death had nothing to do with you, and you know it. At least you gave that bastard Stewart something to think about.
Yeah. And I hope they give him hell with Pentridge.
What do you imagine would happen to Vera if she ended up on this side of the bars?
Yeah, there was Wally, too. Another victim of the Bryant touch. And Mickey.
You don't know about those two. They probably got off with a warning. Mickey didn't end up in here, did she?
Well, there's been nothing in the news.
Well, no news is good news, eh?
Yeah.
So why aren't you getting down the dumps about nothing? Come on, out with it.
You never worked as a prostitute, did you?
I thought that was the problem.
I used to know some of them in the gay bars, you know. I used to be treated like dirt by everybody in the place. It wasn't always their faults. I mean, yeah, some of them had habits to support, but some of them had little kids that they had to support because some bastard had run out on them. I always swore I'd never get that bad.
But you had a damn good reason too, Jude.
Did I?
Well, how else could you have got Jock Stewart?
I tell you what I was gonna do. I was gonna kill him. Then I end up working for him. Now, that's crazy.
Well, what you did was better. He's going to have to live with that for a damn long time, and I wouldn't be in his shoes for anything. Now, isn't that worth turning yourself in for?
Turning myself in was easy. Just if it was worth it.
What do you mean?
Well, what do you think would happen to Vera if she was in here?
They'd probably stick her in isolation so we couldn't get at her.
Exactly. And don't you think they have isolation at Pentridge?
I'll leave them. He's trying to cheer poor old Jude up, that's all.
Hey, Doreen.
It's best I could do in the time.
Oh, it's beautiful.
No, it's a cheap one, but it's a thought that counts.
Oh, I owe you for this, Sandy. I'm just going to the kitchen, Lizzie.
A door you just bend.
Uh-huh.
Oh, God, what's she up to now?
Oh, don't tell me that's this week's rosters.
No, some course of David Andrews. Hand-delivered by the department. Don't know why he bothered having them rushed in. They're going to be of no interest to our lot.
I don't think anything would.
Well, the sooner he realises that, the better. Well, if they're so important, he can collect them. Damned if I'm going to fetch and carry for him.
I'm going that way. I'll take them.
No, leave them there.
Look, like it or not, he's a fact of life here now. The best we can do is hope that he wakes up to himself as far as the women are concerned.
You've changed your tune, haven't you?
Well, we've got enough problems keeping the women in line without squabbling amongst ourselves.
David!
Doreen, what are you doing here?
Oh, I'm collecting the dirty laundry, but I just wanted to see you.
Well, you won't find any dirty linen here. You better get back before you're missed.
I will, but I wanted to see you.
Doreen, when I get these new classes on the go, I'll see you in the library during school period. Now, that's the only time. You understand that, don't you?
Yeah, I understand.
I hope so, because I mean it.
Well, I've got something for you.
What is it?
Here, take it.
Where'd you get this?
Don't you like it?
Well, yes, I do, but I can't take it.
Why not? No one will ever know.
Where'd you get this, Doreen?
A friend gave it to me.
Well, then take it back. I'm sorry, I appreciate the thought, but I can't accept it.
But I just wanted to give you something.
Doreen, I'm sorry, but I meant what I said.
Burns, what are you doing here?
Thanks for not being too hard on her, Vera. It was my fault. I took advice on letting her know where she stands.
I hope you told her in a way she'd understand.
Oh, I think so. My problem is that I don't want to upset the others by hurting Doreen. It's sort of a catch-22 situation. They could cut me off altogether.
There's a simple solution to that. Make the lessons compulsory. If you give them a choice, they can't handle it. Tell them they're going and they'll accept it.
True, but I'm going to need some cooperation if it's to be a success.
You'll never get it.
No, you're probably right, but it's my job to try.
Thank you.
Who's back? Roll out the red carpet. Where the hell have you been?
I just needed an excuse to get out for a while.
Oh, yeah, and how is Mr. Andrews?
How did you know?
Didn't take much figuring out. What's Sandy Hamilton got to do with it?
Well, I wanted to give him something, a present, and she gave me a ring.
What? Let me see.
That's a bit of a butch-looking ring for a woman, isn't it?
How did she get this in?
Well, her boyfriend must have slipped it to her when he came in to visit.
You know, for a first-timer, she knows the ropes just a bit too well.
Yeah, there's something funny about her, strikes me.
Yeah, well, I reckon she's a pain in the ass. She's always hanging around me asking me questions just because I was on TV.
You got to get rid of that, Doreen. And we are going to find out a bit more about our Miss Hamilton.
I only wanted to give him something nice.
Yeah, but Bee's right. If the screws spot that, you'll have a lot of explaining to do. Tell you what, how about give him something personal, you know? Knit him some socks or something like that.
Yeah, that's a great idea. I got some bits and pieces of wool in my cell. Jeez, Lizzie, you should have seen the way he stuck up for me in front of Vera, you know? He's real terrific.
Good night, Jim.
Good night, Julie.
End of another day?
For some people.
Must take some getting used to working all those shifts.
Oh, only a few years. Once you settle into the job, you sort of get used to it. Not that that'll ever be your problem.
No, that's true. It's one of the perks of being a teacher. But there are disadvantages, like being misunderstood.
Mr. Andrews, let's stop playing games, shall we? We both know what you're talking about, and we know each other's feelings on the subject, so let's just leave it at that, shall we?
My feelings, exactly. Forget it ever happened.
I wouldn't do that if I were you, not if you want to make a success of working in this place.
No, no. I didn't mean it that way. Well, I'd better get going. Good night.
Good day, Jude.
Oh, it's you.
Mind if I come in, have a chat?
No, suit yourself.
Hey, listen. I'm sorry if I upset you before. Didn't mean to pry. It's just, oh, well, it's like meeting a film star or something, a celebrity.
I'm pretty sick and tired of the way the media take everything and just change it around to suit themselves. They don't report facts anymore, just their impressions of the facts or some political view that their boss has.
You mean like everything they said about your claims was lies?
No, it wasn't lies. Not lies. They just gloss over the facts, you know. Facts like that Gillespie would still be here if we hadn't escaped, that the place would be run like a concentration camp. They branded me as a danger to society because I tried to expose the fact that they covered up Jock Stewart killing Sharon Gilmore. Now, what's the point in talking about this? You can't change a system.
Oh, no, Jude, that's not completely true. Some people have.
Yeah, well, thousands have been crippled trying.
Well, still, you sure gave them a run for their money before they caught you, didn't they?
They didn't catch me. I gave myself up.
Really? Why?
I don't want to talk about this, Sandy.
Sorry. Sure, I just find it fascinating that you spent so long on the run, you know? You must have had help, huh?
Will you excuse me? Oh, watch where you're going, Doreen.
Geez, you're in a hurry. Where's Sandy?
Oh, in my cell.
Hi.
Hi.
What's up with Jude?
Oh, I think I upset her, Doreen. I'm a bit of a nosy person, really. I ask a lot of questions, but I kind of get excited when I meet someone who's been on the TV.
Well, she's a bit down lately. She's been like that ever since she got back. But look, what I wanted to really see you about was I wanted to give you this back.
Didn't work, huh?
No, he said he couldn't take it.
Oh, that's a shame. Well, you keep it anyway.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can. Gary doesn't need it. And anyway, it's a gift, one friend to another.
Yeah. I'd rather give it back, honest. I mean, thanks and everything, but...
All right. Well, I'll keep it safe, and if you ever need it, you know where it is.
Yeah, thanks.
Hey, Doreen, you know that escape that happened?
Yeah.
Were you around at the time?
Oh, of course I was. I was in it.
You were?
Yeah. You see, we got out through this tunnel that led into the cellars, and the roof collapsed. I hurt my leg. I still get a twinge every now and again, but I was lucky I didn't have to have it off.
Really? Mm. Hey, that must have been exciting.
No, it was scary, really.
Oh. Well, could you, tell me about it?
Sure, if you're interested.
Yeah, I am.
Well, Lizzie was the first one with the idea, so she found this book that was all about Wentworth about 100 years ago.
Bloody woman.
Well, we're allowed to ask or do a guess.
Sandy.
What's she up to now?
I don't know what it is about her, you know? But every time she gets near me, she drives me mad. She gives me the third degree.
You're not the only one, love.
Who else?
Practically everyone I've spoken to. You know, there's something pretty fishy about that lady. She knows as much jargon as any old lag I've ever met. And it's pretty funny the way she managed to get that ring in for Doreen. If she's a first-timer, I'm Father Christmas.
What do you reckon? You think she's working for the screws?
I don't know. All the women I spoke to said the same thing. They reckon that she asked questions about you and the escape.
Me?
Yeah. Now, like I said, I don't know. But I wouldn't be surprised if our Miss Hamilton is working for the police.